sind dann der Prof von Luxembourgish with Anne. In this lesson, you will learn how to say in Luxembourgish, I like doing something. For example, I like to go to the dentist, for example. In Luxembourgish, this sentence construction works a little bit different from the English language. But let's get started. Bist du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! If you want to say in Luxembourgish, I like doing something, you have to use the adverb gär. Now listen and repeat after me for the correct pronunciation, gär. Now you will hear as well native speakers say gären. This means exactly the same, so you can say gär or gären. Let's start with the word order when using the adverb gär. First, when you have a normal sentence, so a statement, you will have to put gär immediately after the main verb. So you will have the sentence construction, subject, verb, and gär. Now, never put gär immediately after ösch, so don't say ösch gär. This doesn't exist, huh? No. You always have to put a verb before gär. Let's have some examples. Ösch tanze gär, or you can say ösch tanze gären. Ösch spiele gär tennis. Ösch spiele gär tennis. You see, you have ösch, your verb, and gär. Men kanna iese gär glas. Men kanna is the subject, iesen is the verb, and then gär. My children like to eat ice cream. Men kanna iese gär glas. Ösch mache gär sport. Ösch mache gär sport. Now let's see the word order when you want to ask someone, do you like doing something? Well, it's the same, just that you start with your verb and then your subject and then gär. So you will have verb, subject and gär. Let's have some examples. How would you ask someone, do you like cooking? Well, to cook is in Luxembourgish kochen. So you start with the verb kochs and then your subject du and then gär. Kochst du gär? Kochst du gär? Easy, isn't it? Now, how would you ask someone, do you like to cycle? So to cycle is in Luxembourgish velo fuhren. So here the verb is fuhren. So when you ask this question to someone you know or in an informal situation, you use du. So you have fährst du gär velo? Fährst du gär velo? Or gehst du gär mit mir etwas trinken? Gehst du gär etwas mit mir trinken? Or gib dir gär du weekend an de Restaurant? Gib dir gär du weekend an de Restaurant? Great! Have a look on how to say in Luxembourgish, I like to go. Well, you probably know that I go is in Luxembourgish, ösch gin. Okay, ösch gin. But if you want to say I like to go, you will hear native speakers saying ösch giger. Ösch giger. Why? Well, this is because of our tricky Luxembourgish N rule. If you don't know what the N rule is, you can check this lesson on my blog, luxembourgishwithn.lu/blog/N rule. Okay, and it is very important to be aware of this N rule so that you understand native speakers in conversations and that you recognize this chunk, as I call it. So it is ösch giger. For example, if you want to say, I like to go shopping in Luxembourg City, you will say ösch giger anstatt einkaufen. Ich gehe gern anstatt einkaufen. And when you have a second verb, you will put it at the very end of the sentence. Say we like to go to the swimming pool is. So we like to go is mir gehe gern und mir gehe gern an schwimmen. Mir gehe gern an schwimmen. I like to go for a walk with the dog is. Ich gehe gern mit dem Hund spazieren. Ich gehe gern mit dem Hund spazieren. Or to say, my parents like to go to concerts, this is. Mein Eltern gehe gern auf Konzerten. Mein Eltern gehe gern auf Konzerten. Or they like to go to the hairdresser is. Sie gehe bei der Coiffeur. Sie gehe bei der Coiffeur. Great. Let's finish this lesson by learning how to say in Luxembourgish I don't like doing something or I don't like doing something at all. So if you want to say I don't like doing something, use nicht gehe. And if you don't like doing something at all, use gue nicht gehe. So nicht gehe or gue nicht gehe. Nicht gehe and gue nicht gehe immediately come after the main verb. Let's have an example to say I don't like to go to the dentist is Ich gehe nicht gern bei den Zahndoktor. Ich gehe nicht gern bei den Zahndoktor. So put nicht gern immediately after gehen. Okay? And to say I don't like doing sports at all is Ich mache gar nicht gern Sport. Ich mache gar nicht gern Sport. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this lesson. And if you want to practice, you can head over to my blog and you can download the whole PDF copy of this lesson. So the transcript with the examples and very important with an exercise, Übung, so that you can practice what you have learned today. Thank you for listening and for watching. Merci für t'nou lauschtren und für t'nou gucken. Adi!